even any payment being attached to it. Like in Hindu adoption, it clearly provides it should not be linked with any payment. Otherwise, it's a penal offense. So that's why we have to see all that aspect also.
I'd like to just supplement.
Quick comment, Charlie.
I just I totally agree that a lot of them are poor, unempowered women. But I also must confess that the money is good, which tempts women. And in a lot of states, in a lot of cities like Anand and all, it's actually an industry. In every house, you have a surrogate mother. So definitely you need to cap the number of surrogate children a woman can have, because someone will tempt me with money and I'll get tempted. But the state is responsible for my health and my well-being. And also regarding this age, I think it's a little, I'm not in favor of this.
Like at one time there were professional blood donors.
Yes, there were. Well, before I get Dr. Sharma's viewpoint, this is Puneet from Gwalior with us. So Puneet, if you're there with me, welcome to the show.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Ma'am, I was just talking about ki how much the mother, surrogate mother will get, how much wages, the money he will get, it should be regularized. Because all the money goes to the clinic, and the surrogate mother is a poor woman.
Correct.
And does not get the actual amount of money which she is supposed to get.
Absolutely.
So I want to, some regulation should be there to
that effect.
There is 40% to 50% to the actual surrogate mother.
Right. Well, that's a good point, and let's see what Dr. Sharma would have to say on this.
First point, Mr. Jagdish mentioned about this commercial surrogacy in the world. So for my information goes, the surrogacy in the whole world is concerned, around 30 countries are there who have performed the surrogacy. Out of that, certainly there are some major countries, 11 states in the United States of America, which permit commercial surrogacy. The Russia permit commercial surrogacy. The Israel permit commercial